Hello everyone and welcome. This is the third video, video number 3 in my course about Python for beginners. So in this course we will talk about string. So string is let's exit this and go ahead to Python. So in Python, a string is an abyss of data that is captured between two single quotes. So every piece of data that captured between these quotes, any name, any word between these single quotes is defined in Python as a string. So let's define some word. Let's say that we have in this command line sentences will be, let's say, my name is here. And hit enter, and we have, let's say, number string will be 44, and hit enter, and let's say that also we have variable which is the first number will be, let's say, 50, and we have the second, number which will be 20, and hit enter. So we have defined four different variables. We have now the challenge to print these variables. So we will hit print and let's say first number and hit enter. And it's print successfully 50. Let's say that we have print first number. And so let's again hit print first number and hit the first number. So if first number is first number, but here is the first number which is defined as variable name, but when we inserted the first number between single quotes, it's defined this first number as a string. It's defined in the memory of your computer as a new variable name which has a name which has a name different than first number. And this is in simple form we have talked about the string. Let's move to the second one, which is integer. So computers are really great at making mass and making complicated calculations using your PC, such as games. Python stores whole numbers data as integer. An integer is simply plain whole number. If you want to make our variables to store integers, so integer may be like 40, let's say 100, maybe 1000, maybe 500, maybe 33. All these numbers are integer and defined in Python and in your memory and integer, and you can after that make calculations use these numbers. Let's go to Python command line and hit enter. So we will define the first number. Let's say the number 1 in more detail will be, let's say, 20, and the number 2 will be 50, and let's have result, or we can print that we will print number 1 plus number 2. We expected that it will print 70. That's fine. Let's say that we have number, let's say go ahead, and the number 3 will be 50. Define 50, and let's say that we have number 3 will be 50, and we have number also 4 will be 10. Let's say that we have result will be number 3 multiplied or plus number 4, and we have now a challenge to print this result in this new line. We expect that will print 60. So we can say that we have number 1 also again, that number 1 will be, let's say, 33, and number 2 will be 44, and you may see that Python is dynamic language, so we have defined number 1 will be 20, and we have we here defined the number 1 to be 33. It has no issue with that convention and with that naming, and we have now just challenged to print number 1 multiplied by number 2, and let's see the result. We have some wrong here. Number 1 multiplied by number 2, let's see, it will print this number. So let's again say that we have number 1 will be, you can make any calculations with these naming variables, and also without numbers you can using calculation. Let's say that we have 20 divided by 2, let's say 6, we have 10 multiplied by 10, it will print 100, and we have 5 plus 20, 25, let's have 44 minus 3, 42. Let's see that we have 100 plus 400, which is 500, and also you can make any calculations using this command prompt and these simple naming variables. And let's go to the final type in this video, which is the float. Float is the decimal numbers like this, and like let's say 20, and let's say 33. All these numbers are defined in memory as floats. So floats are really fancy way of saying numbers using decimal. Setting numbers as float allow us to do some more complicated math using fractional numbers. Let's go ahead to the command prompt and see how we can do these calculations. Let's close this window and go ahead again and start the command prompt. Let's say that we have number 1 will be 4.3, and we have number 2 will be, let's say, 5.3. And we have now result, which is the number 1 multiplied by number 2. We have now the challenge to print the result. Let's hit enter and hit print. And let's say that we have result will be number 1 divided by number 2. Let's now print the result, and it shows the result. We can also using the command to make a more complicated operations, like let's say that we have this multiplied by point, let's say that number, and it shows the result. Or you can multiply this number, multiply this now, and it shows the result very easily. And so this was the third video in my course about Python for beginners. If you hope enjoying this video, please subscribe to my channel on YouTube and leave a comment in this video.